We shall start now. First, I would like to give introduction of this course, that is physiological modeling. Teaching scheme for this course is we'll be having 4 lectures per week, and each lecture is assigned a time period of 50 minutes. Examination scheme related with this course is we'll have a mid-sem exam. And weightage for this mid-sem exam will be 30 marks. We'll have a continuous assessment through assignments. I'll give you assignments, and we will use Google Classroom for assessment and submission of these assignments. So these assignments will have a weightage of 10 marks, and there is a weightage of 10 marks for attendance, and for NSEM exam, weightage will be 50 marks. So thus, this is how a total 100 marks evaluation will be done for theory course. And for course project, I'll assign course project to each one. We'll keep a weightage of 30 marks for mid-SEM report. I'll give you some questions based on the course project that is assigned. And you need to submit the report before the mid-sem. So that will have a weightage of 30 marks. Then your end-sem presentation will have a weightage of 20 marks. And final course project report submission, that is the end-sem report submission, will have a 50 marks. So this is how your course project evaluation will be done. So let us discuss the syllabus and the course content. This course content, this is the first unit, or you can say a first part of your physiological modeling. This first part consists of some topics which are listed here. The first topic is we'll have introduction of physiological modeling. Then we'll understand importance of physiological modeling. Why we need to model the physiological system? What is the need and what are the applications? Then we'll see how classification of these models is done. Then we'll learn a few features like characteristics of the model, then how model simulation is done, how model validation is done, and what are the time invariant and time varying systems which are used for physiological modeling. This concept is same as that of your control system, time invariant and time varying systems. But we'll see this in physiological modeling point of view. Now our next module deals with electrical model. In this module, we'll see models of neuron, that is electromotive, resistive, and capacitive properties of like before starting the model, we'll first study the cell membrane. What is the structure of the cell membrane, anatomy of the cell membrane, and what are its different properties, and how you can find out analogy between the cell membrane and any electronic component, or how to find out the electrical analogy before designing electrical models. And then we'll move towards actual model. So we'll develop this model from starting, like we'll first study the physiology, then find out the analogy based on the physiology, and then we'll design this model step by step, and then finally we'll see what are the different models which are available, like HH model is available, and how it is analyzed, like what is its strength duration curve, and then we'll see how you can model the whole neuron. So basically in this module you will learn the concept of electrical models, like how you can use electrical perspective to model a system. This is by using one example, that is we are going to model the neuron in electrical perspective. Now the next module is mechanical models, where we are going to model the physiological system in mechanical perspective. In mechanical perspective, for this, we'll have an example of muscle modeling, as well as like In muscle modeling, specifically, we'll see eye movement model because that is the simplest model, simplest muscle model of the human body. So we'll see how you can look a human body in a mechanical point of view, like a mechanical structure and movement and how it moves, how the locomotion happens, and all these things. So in this module, basically, we'll first see the physiology of muscles, how the contraction happens, contraction and relaxation of the muscles happens, starting from anatomy of the muscle to its physiology. And then we'll try to understand how you can represent this physiology in mechanical point of view. Then we'll slowly or gradually start the mechanical modeling from very basic one. First, we'll try to model a single muscle, then we'll add its antagonist to that, and we'll look that muscle in a different perspective. Then we'll add one by one more features, more component, and then finally we'll develop a complete muscle model. For eye movement model, we will not only develop the muscle model, but we'll try to analyze this muscle model and how we can validate this muscle model, that also. Then the next module, in this module, you should acquire a skill of modeling a process. In a first module, we find out how to model an electrical perspective. In second one, we try to model in mechanical perspective. Here, we will learn to model the process and the example or the application to learn the skill or to learn this perspective that we have taken is nothing but the thermoregulatory process of the human body. That is how human body temperature is maintained. So we will try to model this process. We call it as a thermoregulation. So we'll try to model the thermoregulation. So what are the different perspective? Compartmental modeling is used and process modeling is used. So how these pers how you can model this in different perspective that we are going to learn. And then we will apply this knowledge or this skill to the modeling of immunoresponse. For example, one kind of a viral infection happens to a particular subject or a group of the subject. Then what is the process? How that viral infection proceeds or what happens to that infection? What are the levels and if a particular, say, for n number of population that infection, n number of population got infected for that particular virus, then what happens? How many people will actually get infected? How many people will actually are immune to that and can be immune to that and what happens? So we will model this complete process like a thermoregulation. So this is what is in this unit we will learn how we can model the process. Now finally or the at last, these are the few models like a model of drug delivery. Other models we will study. Modeling of insulin glucose feedback system, model of drug delivery, like how you can, what is the response of the drug when it is injected inside the human body. So we'll try to understand this process and we'll try to model it. Similar to that, insulin is a drug. As an application of this model, we have considered as insulin as a drug. So we'll try to model the insulin glucose feedback system, a complete feedback system, how it works as an example. So this is the curriculum, this is the syllabus which we are going to study in the subject. So we'll revise for, in short, we'll study physiological modeling. Then we'll try to model, we'll try to understand and we'll acquire a skill of electrical modeling. And then we'll acquire a skill of mechanical modeling for physiological systems. Then we'll try to understand how to model the processes, different processes, physiological processes. And with this, again, with this, we'll study few models like model of drug delivery or modeling of insulin glucose feedback system. So this is the syllabus of this course. These are the course outcomes. You should be able to acquire, I mean, you should be able to acquire knowledge of physiological system with ability to evaluate, analyze, and synthesize knowledge related to physiological systems and biomedical instrumentation perspectives, and analyze complex problem related to this biomedical instrumentation, and extract knowledge related to complex biomedical system through literature survey, experimentation, and appropriate research methodology techniques, and we will learn few contemporary tools. So these are the reference books for you. I'm going to provide you notes of every lectures. Also, I have a hard copy of all the three books, okay, and even I have a soft copy of third one. For first one, you can take a Xerox copy of that. Second one, if you don't take, then also it's okay. I mean, that material is available online, and I'll share the soft copy of the third book with you. Up till now, if you have any query, please discuss. Are you guys in line with me, all of you?
Yes, yes ma'am.
Okay,
Yes
do you
ma'am.
have any query?
Yes ma'am.
Do you have any query or doubt?
No ma'am, no.
Ma'am, how will be the marking scheme related to this electrical model, mechanical model, all this respective things?
Question paper, it will depend on the question paper setting, final question paper setting. No, I mean, no discretized marking scheme is here. And don't worry,
Okay,
I
ma'am.
mean, questions won't be straightforward or clear-cut objective kind of thing, because ultimately this is a skill-based course. So we try to keep it in more towards application oriented. Anything else? Okay, if no doubt, then we'll move ahead. We'll start with the introduction of this modeling, physiological modeling. First, try to understand what is modeling. Why you need to go for the modeling and what is modeling? In engineering, in practical applications, or in industry, or in healthcare, many times we come across the situation where, like, we can't apply our knowledge or the design system directly. For example, you have designed one instrument and which will be applied on the human body. So without testing, without full testing of that instrument, you cannot use that instrument on the human body, because you don't know how what will be the output or what will be the response of that instrument. In this case, what is done is a model to test its exact response in different scenarios, for different scenarios, for all kinds of variabilities. What is done is this environment or the human body is simulated, or we model the human body with environment or with its effect, with all the variabilities, and then we will test our methodology or instrument on that model so that we can analyze the whole spectrum of our methodology or our design. So, see, practically, this is not possible. This is because, though you will get permission to directly apply on the human body, first of all, for a few grades, you won't get a permission. But though if you will get, it is practical, it is not possible to work with all kind of practical scenarios. Like in case of ECG, you don't get each and every abnormality in the subject to test your instrument. However, you can generate that abnormalities with modeling. How you can do this? You can model the abnormalities. How the abnormalities happens? What is the electrical signal or what is the ECG signal for that particular abnormality? And you can actually generate one instrument which will deliver that abnormal signal. You just say your instrument that I want to say I want to get the signal for atrial fibrillation or ventricular fibrillation, bradycardia, tachycardia. These are the abnormalities of the heart. So you will just say that instrument key, I want the signal for this. And that instrument will deliver that signal. And then you will test your ECG amplifier accordingly, whether your amplifier is giving correct response or not. Because practically, it should work for the whole spectrum, the complete range of the abnormalities. So this is where your role plays. You are going to study that, you are going to model that, and you are going to implement that. You are going to design. Your aim is you should be able to design the final model. It may be in any form. This is the example which I have given where your final model will be an instrument. But it may be any form. So you should be able to design up to that point. So this is the modeling. It's nothing but it's a process of producing a model. Model is nothing but you are replicating the process, you are replicating the system, you are replicating the physiology, you are replicating its response, etc., etc. It's nothing but replication of something. So a model is a representation of the construction and working of some system of interest. While modeling, this is most important. Sometimes it happens that an aim is you are given an aim or objective to model. But in that case, we forget what is my interest. My interest, you should first understand what is the system of interest. I mean, what is the aim for what you are modeling, right? For example, modeling of the heart. Modeling of the heart can happen, will have a different interest or will have a different perspective. Sorry. You can model the heart to understand its physiology, to understand the blood flow, as well as to generate an how electrical signal is generated on the surface of the heart, as well as you can model the heart for sound, like whatever the sounds that are generated by opening and closing of the heart walls. So these are the different perspective. So first thing is you should understand what is the interest. What is the aim for which you are modeling? So a model is similar to, but simpler than the system it represents. Purpose is to enable the analyst to predict the effect of changes to the system. So on the one hand, a model should be a close approximation to the real system and incorporate most of its salient features. But what happens? When you want to incorporate all the features, at the same time, model complexity increases. And you know, as the model complexity increases, obviously your mathematical complexity will also increase if you are representing that model in mathematical terms. Then again, with that, if you are doing its hardware implementation, then your implementation or hardware implementation complexity will also increase. So it is like it becomes complex in that in implementation point of view, in experimentation point of view. So ultimately, what you have to do is you have to find out the trade-off between these two, realism and the simplicity. What we have to do is we have to decide a cutoff. Say, I want to design a model for this much accuracy. It should be this much accurate. It should be this much precise. आइडियली इट शुड गिव यू अ बेस्ट ऑफ द बेस्ट सिनेरियो, बट प्रैक्टिकली दिस इज नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी इंक्रीजेस, एंड बिकॉज ऑफ दैट वी हैव टू कीप अ बैलेंस बिटवीन बोथ कॉम्प्लेक्सिटी एंड द फीचर्स. सो दैट्स वाई इट इज मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द मॉडलिंग, बिफोर डिसाइडिंग द मेथडोलॉजी इट सेल्फ, योर ऑब्जेक्टिव शुड बी क्लियर फॉर वॉट यू आर मॉडलिंग एंड वॉट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव, लाइक वॉट इज द एक्यूरेसी दैट यू वॉन्ट, वॉट इज द प्रिसीजन दैट यू वॉन्ट, वॉट आर द फीचर्स दैट यू वॉन्ट टू कवर. सो यू शुड फोकस ऑन दैट फीचर्स. Sometimes you can reduce the complexity by assuming something. Okay, for example, how you can reduce the complexity and how you can solve the problem or how you can design the model step by step. One of the example is, say you want to model for drug response. So in that case, first try to model for a single subject, where say consider a subject whose weight is fixed and whose height is fixed, whose BMI is fixed and all the physics, and then try to change one feature, then another, then another. In this case, once your objectives are fixed, in this case you can build a model from a single compartment to a fourth or fifth compartment kind of a model, and that to be state by state. So this is the methodology that you should follow. So basically, why modeling? Engineers are modeling new as well as existing systems. So models of existing systems help engineers to clarify what the existing systems does and can be used as a basis for discussing its strength and weaknesses. In human physiology, sometimes to understand the physiology, modeling of the physiological system is done. Like you want to study your respiratory system, so you will model the respiratory systems to study how, what is its anatomy and how it works and how you can inspire and expire the air, what is the role of the lungs, etc. So this is the example. These then lead to requirement for the new system. So models of the new systems are used during the requirement engineering to help explain the proposed requirements to other system stakeholders. This is the engineering perspective. But in physiological modeling perspective, see, you are modeling the physiological systems not only to understand its physiology, but also to apply your knowledge, to apply your methodology, to control something. For example, I want to, or our aim is to design blood glucose monitoring as well as blood glucose control system. So in this case, you are monitoring the blood glucose and you are continuously delivering the insulin dose. So what should be the level of the insulin drug dosing? That depends on what is the blood glucose level. Not only the current blood glucose level, but also what is the food intake, what is the exercise and all these things. So in this case, what we are doing is we are controlling the insulin pump. We are controlling the blood glucose level ultimately by delivering the insulin continuously. So in this case, this is where we will model this complete closed loop blood glucose system to understand, not only to understand the physiology, but to control it, to control and to maintain the blood glucose level. So these are the two perspectives where we need the modeling. So that's why we are doing this modeling. So how models can explain the system from different perspectives? So these are the different perspectives. So an external perspective, where you model the context or environment of the system. An interaction perspective, where you model the interaction between the system and its environment. For example of the interaction system is, say you want to model one electrode. What is the we are using one skin surface electrode, and you are asked to model that skin surface electrode. So this is an interaction kind of an perspective, where that what will be the reaction between electrode and the skin surface or the human body. Then structural perspective, where you model the organization of the system or the structure of the data or the process. And a behavioral perspective, where you model the dynamic behavior of the system. Like what is the response, like drug response model, that is a dynamic behavior or behavioral perspective. So these are the four main perspective by which we can model the physiological systems. So has anyone any doubt up till this point?
Ma'am, I have to ask one question.
Yes, please.
Ma'am, as you said, for modeling, we can make replica of it by introducing vibrations and all. But if we want to make brain's replica, where the signals are, when the signals are just assumed, how those replicas are made then?
Replica means model. So we are modeling, keeping its, what is the features that you want. For brain modeling, whether you want to study it, you want its physical model or you want its electrical model. If you want its electrical model, its electrical signal is EEG, that is called as electroencephalogram. So what in physical model, you will physically model it by using some material and you will give it shape and etc. etc. But when you are going for electrical modeling, ultimately what you want is the electrical signal that is generated on the surface of the brain. So in that case, what you can do is you can generate that EEG signal. We call it as EEG simulator. We call the model as stimulator because it stimulates that signal. Okay. So how this stimulator is designed? So it is like there is a 10-20 electrode system for acquiring that EEG signal. So we'll choose each and every electrode, and there is a sample signal, how it is generated. So we'll model what is the signal for that particular electrode, and on selection of that particular electrode, that your stimulator will deliver that signal. So this is how electrical and physical modeling has a difference.
Okay, man, means for every body part, there are various replicas to be made.
Yes.
Okay.
Physical replica, physical model has a different significance. But and another, like electrical model has a different thing. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Is there anything? We have a patient simulator. I'll show you that instrument. It's actually a best example of the model, electrical model. When you will come on campus, I'll show you that instrument. Anyone else? No, no one has any doubt. So shall we move ahead? Okay, are you guys are in line with me?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, fine. So before starting the further topic, I just want to give I just want to discuss few things.